describe motion of an object along a straight line. It may be uniform or non-uniform. It depends on position, velocity and acceleration. But what causes the motion? That we don't know it. So do all motions require a cause? Thus, these all queries can be solved in this lesson. For many centuries, a problem of motion and its causes had puzzled scientists and philosophers. Suppose a ball on a ground, when given small heat, it does not move forever. So, in this lesson, we will see about the definition of force, then effects of the force, characteristic of the force, and distinguish between balance and unbalanced force. For example, when we give small heat to the ball or we push the boulder or stop the moving vehicle, in these all cases there is need of one physical quantity in order to change its position. So the physical quantity which need or required to give the velocity or move any object, it may be pulled, push or hit, then this quantity is called as the force. So in everyday life, we observe that some effort is required to put a stationary object. For example, hitting of the ball is done with foot, then boulder is pushed with our hands and moving vehicle is stopped by applying the force with the hand. Thus, we must push, hit or pull on any object to change its state of motion. Thus, concept of force is based on this push, hit or pull. Let us now ponder about a force. What is it? So, for example, when one person comes with his hat and hat fall down due to the force which is due to the fan or wind, then the another person when keep its foot on it, it needs to remove or move that person in order to take the cap. So what it needs? It requires some of the push or the pull in order to remove that hat. Thus, when it pushes, that person falls down. Another example, if dog, we are carrying it, tied it with any rope and we are moving with that dog, then in order to stop that running dog, we need to pull it. So what it requires? It requires the force to pull it. It can only be explained by describing what happens when force is applied to an object by pushing, hitting and pulling of the object. So can you see that some of the examples, what is the force and what is its effect? So from our studies, from this everyday life examples, we can say that the fact that force can be used to change the magnitude of velocity of an object, that is to make the object move faster or slower, or to change its direction of moving object. Now here we can see that hat falls down and it keeps its leg on it. So in order to remove that cap, it is pushing that person and it is getting its hat. Now trolley, when trolley is moving from one place to another place, or toy box, when we are moving, then everywhere there is need of the force. In order to stop that running ball, it needs force to apply there. Thus, from these examples, three examples, we can see that hitting of the ball with the hockey stick in the given direction, when we apply the force in forward or backward direction, in the same direction that object moves. Thus, force needs magnitude as well as specific direction. So what we can say here? Force is vector quantity. Now what are the effects of force? Force, when we take balloon and when we are rolling it, then at that time it changes its shape. First, it was in the straight. And when we apply the force on it, it changes its shape. For example, rubber band, kitchen sponge, and the bag, bean bag. Everywhere when we stretch, compress, or we sit on it, then it changes its original shape. Thus, we can say that force can change the shape and size of the object. Now, we can see what are the characteristic of the force. There are two types of the force, that is balance force and unbalanced force. We will see those examples. Now we have taken the box. The magnitude of the force, if small box is there, its mass is less, then it needs less force to apply. But if it is big box, it needs more force to apply, then only it can move from one place to another place. What is SI unit? Its unit is Newton. Now, if we have taken the big box and we are trying to push it, when we apply more power force on it, then it shows change in its motion. Means from the rest position, it starts moving. For the small box, it needs less amount of force. For big box, it require more amount of the force to apply by our hand. Thus, magnitude of the force is important, and direction in which it is applied in the same direction it moves. Thus, force require both magnitude and direction. So, use of action means action of any object is in the direction of application of the force. When we keep book on the table, force is in downward direction. And in second example, if we push in the forward direction, then book moves in the forward, that is in the direction of the force applied. Thus, characteristic of the force is that motion of any object is in the direction of the force. When we are hitting the ball or any small stone with the stick, then it goes in the forward direction, that is direction of the hitting. So, force is applied in which direction? In the same direction, it shows its motion. So, force can be push or pull on the body. Thus, it shows the motion. In which direction we have pushed any object, in the same direction it goes forward. Now, we can see the effect of force on the body. It depends on the part on which it is applied. So, when head of person is fall down and the person is pushing from the back, then that person falls down. The point of application was at the downside part of the body. And when it is applied at the center of the body, that person moves in straight away. But if force is applied at the end part of the body or on the leg, then that person falls down. So, effect of the force on a body depends on the position of application or point of application that you can see in this figure or in this picture. You can easily understand the force depends on the point of application. Thus, force is a vector quantity which depends on the magnitude as well as the direction in which it is applied. Now, simple example we can see the rope pulling. So, while pulling the rope, if at both sides magnitude of application of the force is same, then it remains at the same position. But if the magnitude of the force is more at the side, at that direction it gets pulled. If magnitude is less, then it cannot be pulled. Thus, where there is magnitude, there that rope can be pulled easily. So it may be in the back and throw direction. Thus, this force is called as means unbalanced force. Let us, you can consider these two situations. Thus, one, the two opposite forces of different magnitudes pull the rope or the block where there is greater force. You can see with the arrow. The net force on the body is non-zero, then it can be pulled at the side where there is more force. Thus, we have taken two objects. If it is pulled, then net force, if F1 is greater than F2, then it is pulled towards the F1. If on the object A, when we are forcing in the opposite direction, thus force acting in the opposite direction where F1 is greater than F2, then this object B is pulled or moved towards the force where there is more magnitude. In this case, the block would begin to move in the direction where there is greater force, or rope will be pulled where there is more force. Thus, two forces are not balanced, and unbalanced force acts in the direction of the rope where is it applied. This suggests that the unbalanced force acting on an object brings its motion. If two forces are of equal magnitude, then they remain at the rest. But why these persons fell down? Because the force applied by these persons is more, and this rope is pulled where there is greater force. Thus, net force is no longer zero. Now, another example we can see. If we have seen big block, and at from the both side two persons are pushing this block, and when this force is balanced, if F1 is equal to F2, that is forward and backward force are same or equal, then that object cannot move from the place. But from that F1 is more than that F2, then that block will move in the direction of F1. The change in speed is in the direction of the motion in which force is applied. Now another example, friction. When we are hitting, or cricketer is hitting the ball, at that time there is frictional force between surface of the ball and that ground. Thus, it balances the pushing of the force, and therefore the ball stop. Thus, the friction force still balance the pushing force. If the children push or hit, that cricketer hits the ball, then hitting force, it becomes more till that time that ball move from one place to another place on the ground. But what this bowler tried to stop that ball, when there is a zero frictional force, then at that time ball stops. If we'll take the example of the means wooden box, and if that is rough surface, then when this boy is trying to push the box, at that time it balances the pushing force, and therefore box does not move. But if there is no balancing force, then it moves from one place to another place. It makes a friction. This is because the friction force still balances the pushing force. If the pushing is done on the harder or heavy box, then it needs more pushing force. It becomes bigger. So, in all these examples, on dais we have kept the notebook. Then it remains at the rest position. due to the balance force. Now we are writing letters on the board with the help of chalk. Then it is a rough surface. There is also friction force between chalk and the surface. Here rope, then pushing of the box, heavy box, then small box. Everywhere we can see the application of the force on these objects. And thus it explains about balance force, unbalanced force and frictional force. You can see here table tennis. When he is hitting with the stick on that ball, at that time the direction in which he has hitted the ball, then all the pieces, they get spread. All the balls get spread. Why? Because application of the force, where pushing, hitting force balances exactly the frictional force. So force is needed for the motion. From these all examples, you can distinguish between balance and unbalanced force. Here, equal forces acts on body in the opposite direction, but unequal forces acts on body in the opposite direction. Force acts, it is zero, and the net force is not the zero. The body will be at rest in balanced force and body will be in moving state in unbalanced force. You have seen many examples. A book when kept on the dais or table, acting force in which weight of the book gives out gravity means cancels out the reaction force of the table and therefore it remains at the same part. In case of unbalanced force, when the book that is kept on the table is pushed to the left side, then it gets pushed towards the left. Galileo Galilei was born on 15 February 1564 in Pisa. He was a mathematician. By observing the motion of the object on an inclined plane, Galileo deduced that objects move with constant speed when no force acts on them. He observed that when a marble rolls down an inclined plane, its velocity increases. It thus suggests that an unbalanced force is required to change the motion of the marble, but no net force is needed to sustain the uniform motion of the marble. Object moves with a uniform velocity when the forces acting on the object are balanced and there is no net external force. Thus, to accelerate any object in motion, there is need of unbalanced force. Now, we can see that means Galileo argued that when the marble is released from left, it would roll down the slope and go up on the opposite side. Newton and Galileo, they both have ideas on the force and motion and presented three fundamental laws that govern the motion of the object. So here in this part, we are going to explain the Newton's first law of motion, then concept of inertia and examples of inertia based on object size. Thus, Newton's first law of motion states that an object remains in a state of rest or in uniform motion in a straight line unless compelled to change that state by an applied force. In other words, an object will remain at rest or continue to move at a constant speed in a specified direction unless an external force acts upon it. Thus, it will remain at the rest or to keep moving with the same velocity. The quantity which is needed is called as inertia. Thus, all objects resist a change in their state of motion. In a qualitative way, the tendency of undisturbed objects to stay at rest or to keep moving with the same velocity is called as inertia. An object will remain at the rest or it will keep moving. That is, object which is in motion will remain in continuous speed or in the continuous motion in a given specific direction when unbalanced external force is applied on it. Thus, you can see this example. certain experiences that we came across while traveling in a motor car also. Thus, this movement of the rocket, satellite or planets can be seen here. Now, friction. Friction force is hidden force that arises between two surfaces in contact with each other. Here, surface of the ball and surface of the ground. Thus, it is present between two surfaces. It acts in a direction opposite to the direction of the force trying to move the object.